singing. There's nothing better than being together when we're singing.
Five of us and Mom working all day. We knew we could help her if our music would pay. Together when Mom sang along.
Come on now and meet everybody and hear us singing. There's nothing better than being together when we're singing. When we're singing. When we're singing.
Now remember, no racing your carts up and down the aisles. We'll meet back at the checkout counter in 15 minutes.
They don't have what's on the list. Can we substitute?
No substitution.
Why not?
Because last week, instead of lamb chops, you bought 3 packages of chocolate cream puffs.
So what's wrong with that? We made a 75-cent savings.
Laurie, would you keep an eye on them, please? Sorry. Excuse me.
Mabel.
Shirley.
Well, I never expected to see a big star like you in a supermarket.
Why? I shop here every week.
Oh, yeah. Well, I guess you want to make sure the kids get a home-cooked meal once in a while.
I try my best.
Oh, I'm sure you do. That's what I was trying to explain to Hortense the other day. Oh, you remember Hortense. She's the girl with the bad skin that replaced you at the bank. Well, I said to Hortense, if anyone can protect those kids from that sordid side of nightclub life, Shirley can.
So nice to have friends who defend you.
Oh, I did. And when Hortense said to me, you name me one child star that grew up normal, well, I came right back at her with Herbie Plankton.
Who?
Herbie Plankton? My nephew. He used to help support the folks by doing those TV commercials. Well, my sister had her problems with him, you know, with a dope thing and all, but he straightened up. He got out of show business, and he's very happy now in his new job.
What job is it?
He's a nurse.
Shirley, don't you think you're making too much of this whole thing?
I don't know. They are keeping irregular hours, and the life they lead could be considered unusual. Oh, Reuben, they're so young. Maybe it is too much of a strain on them.
Look, as soon as I think any of the kids are turning into freaks, I'll tell you. Now, will you sign these contracts for the college tour?
Let's discuss it after the performance tonight.
Shirley.
Look, Reuben, do you want the kids to grow up like Herbie Plankton?
Well, of course not.
Well, neither do I.
Herbie Plankton. Wow, what a great audience. Weren't they too much?
They were really out of sight. I bet we could have stayed out there taking bows all night.
Danny, there's more to life than taking bows.
Not when you're an egomaniac with grease paint in your blood.
It's not grease paint anymore. It's pancake. And it's not in your blood. As a matter of fact, most of it's on the front of your shirt.
So when you're talented, who needs to be neat?
Mom, is there something wrong?
No, nothing. Hurry up, let's get going. I'd like to get home at a decent hour. Come on, Chris. Chris?
Guess he crashed, Mom. Those encores must have got to him.
What do you mean?
He works harder than any of us.
He was really wailing away on those drums tonight.
You know, it must be tough on those puny good alarms. We should do something to build the kid up.
Oh, let him sleep, Mom. I'll carry him out to the bus. You go get changed.
Okay. Okay. But tomorrow, we're all going over to Dr. Michael's office for a complete checkup.
What?
From now on, we're going to start living like a normal family again.
Hey,
Uncle Michael gave me a lollipop.
Just for being healthy?
No, for being a kid. He said for you, go on in. He's almost done with Chris. If he gives you a lollipop, keep it for me.
Not likely, Tracy. I'm not a child.
Can't you fake it?
Would you give Dr. Michaels a message? Shirley? Shirley, it is you. What a wonderful surprise.
Jim, what are you doing here? Did you switch to pediatrics?
No. I have an office down the hall. I was just dropping by to cancel a lunch date with Ted Michaels. Is this Tracy?
Grown a little, hasn't she? Honey, this is Dr. Lucas.
Tracy, you may not know this, but I'm just about your oldest friend. As a matter of fact, I knew you even before you were born.
You sure get around.
Dr. Lucas delivers babies.
Delivers them where?
To their mothers.
Did you deliver me?
I certainly did.
Thank you very much.
You're entirely welcome. Hey, congratulations on your success. That is a terrific sound you have.
Thank you.
And you look terrific.
Thank you again. I feel fine.
I wasn't speaking medically. Doctors are human too, you know.
Oh, thank you. What about you, Jim? I thought you'd be married and raising a brood of your own by now.
No, I just deliver. I leave the care and maintenance to others.
You're smart. The care and maintenance is the hard part.
Dr. Lucas, your office is on the line. Mrs. Medford just arrived at the hospital.
Tell them I'm on my way. Let's not let it go 5 years next time. May I call you?
I'm in the book.
Okay. Bye-bye, Tracy. Excuse me.
Hey, who was that?
He used to be my doctor.
Wow. Why'd you give him up?
Oh, I recovered.
Well, whatever he treated you for, I get it again. Right away.
Hey, I thought we'd rehearse a bit tonight. You know where Chris and Danny are?
I ordered them outside to shoot baskets.
You ordered them?
Look, why don't you forget about rehearsing tonight?
And do what?
I don't know. Might be nice for you and Laurie to go down to the malt shop and see some of your friends.
The malt shop?
Well, wherever young people hang out these days.
Oh, sure, Mom, we'll do that. Hey, how about it, Laurie? Won't that be fun? Maybe Andy Hardy will be there and we can all go over to Polly Benedict's house. The malt shop. Mom, you're beautiful.
Smarty.
Hello? Yes, just a second. Mom, it's him. It's Dr. Groovy. Now, Mom, don't go losing your cool.
What makes you think I am?
Because you were just fixing your hair and he's on the telephone.
Hello? Yes, Jim. Oh, I'd love to. When is it? Oh, I'm so sorry. We'll be out of town performing on Friday. No, the whole weekend, I'm afraid. Sure, some other time. I am too. Bye.
Gee, that's too bad, Mom. Did you really want to go?
Oh, I'll live.
Well, I know how you feel. I was invited to the basketball game on Friday.
Oh, you were? Does it bother you that you can't go?
Oh, I'll live.
So, if any one of you feels that working in the group or being away from home so much is more of a strain on you than you thought it would be, or keeping you from doing other things you'd rather do, then I think you should speak up.
But why?
Because if it's true, then I think we should relax for 6 months and use that time to take a hard look at what we're doing.
6 months? Mom, if we don't work for 6 months, we won't even be able to get a booking at a Sweet 16 party.
Mom, would you mind if we talked this over among ourselves before we gave you an answer?
Okay. What's there to talk about? You know none of us wants to quit.
No, but Mom does.
What?
Look, when we're on the road, she has no social life of her own.
Now she's met a man she likes. If we keep on working, they're not even going to have a chance for anything to develop.
Well, who is this guy?
He's an attractive, eligible doctor.
So, what's so special about that?
Every daughter wants her mother to marry a doctor.
I don't get it. If what you say is true, why doesn't Mom just say she wants to quit?
Because she's very unselfish. She won't put her interests ahead of ours. The point is, are we selfish enough to stand in her way?
I think I am.
How about you, Tracy?
I don't understand the question.
Keith?
She really likes this guy, huh? Well, Mom's made a lot of sacrifices for us.
Maybe we should vote.
Mom, we've come to a decision.
Good.
We've decided we'd like to quit.
Think of anything to do with yourselves?
We're doing fine.
Chris, would you like me to pitch some balls with you?
Maybe later, Mom.
Okay, I'll start dinner. If you want to play ball, call me.
I hope she forgets. Mom's been throwing so many baseballs at me. I've lost a feeling in my right hand.
You're lucky. Yesterday she sent me over to play with Bernard McGuire.
What'd you do?
You ever spend an afternoon with Bernard McGuire? Mostly we sat around and watched each other grow.
Let's do something. Why don't we go out in the garage and rehearse some numbers?
Hey, yeah. Far out.
I don't think we should do that, Keith.
Why not?
Because if we keep going off to rehearse in the garage, Mom's going to think we miss performing.
This is ridiculous. We've been home a week now, and that doctor you say is so crazy about her hasn't even phoned.
He probably thinks we're out of town.
Well, why don't we set him straight?
Because if Mom finds out, she'll kill us.
Not if we did it cleverly.
Hi, Mom. We're glad you're with me.
Oh, Dr. Lucas. I'm Lori. Mother's not here now.
Oh, well, that's all right. I was just dropping Danny off.
But she should be back soon. Let me get you a cup of coffee.
Please.
You sit down, and I'll get it. And Danny, keep the doctor talking. I mean, talk to the doctor.
So how do you feel about Marcus Welby? Where did you guys dream up the name artificial respiration?
Well, hi.
Hi, yourself.
I didn't think doctors made house calls anymore.
I bumped into Danny at the golf course and gave him a lift home.
Thank you, Jim. That's very nice of you. Danny, what were you doing at the golf course?
Well, I was just hanging around.
Hey, kids, I need some help in cleaning out the garage.
We just did that this morning.
Come on, Chris.
Nice kids.
Mm-hmm. But devious.
Oh?
Jim, I think it only fair to tell you, I have a suspicion you're a victim of a little matchmaking setup.
So, to tell you the truth, I was rather surprised when I found out they really wanted to quit. I'm more mixed up than ever now.
Why?
Well, they don't seem to be taking advantage of their freedom. I mean, well, I can't really put my finger on it, but I keep getting the feeling that they know something that I don't.
I get that feeling with everybody under 30.
Oh, this is terrible. Here I've invited you to dinner and spent the whole evening bending your ear about my domestic problems.
I've enjoyed it. What about you, Shirley? Don't you miss the excitement? I mean, that concert in San Francisco, for instance, that must have been really something.
How did you know we played San Francisco?
All right, I'll be honest with you. For the last couple of months, I've been keeping pretty close track of you.
I'm flattered. What is it, Jim?
I want to ask you a question, and I'm trying to decide whether or not I have the nerve.
Oh?
Oh, the heck with it. Shirley? Shirley? Well, you...
Excuse me. Hello? Oh, yes, he's here. It's for you.
Hello, Dr. Lucas. Oh, Mrs. Riley. How far apart are the pains? I see. Well, maybe you'd better get to the hospital. No, I'll meet you there. All right, don't worry. All right, bye-bye. I'm sorry. I'm afraid I have one of those jobs where you just can't put things off till tomorrow.
I understand.
Can I treat you to dinner tomorrow?
I'd like that.
Good.
Do I look all right?
Great for a mother. You seeing Dr. Lucas again tonight?
Uh-huh. Laurie, would you hook me up, please?
That's five times you've seen the good doctor in the past couple of weeks.
I didn't realize anyone was counting.
Where are you going tonight?
His place for dinner.
Sounds promising.
He said he wanted to talk to me about something.
Sounds even better.
Don't let your imagination run away with you, Laurie. Bye, kids.
Good night, Mom.
Be good. Bye, honey.
Have a good time.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Shirley, I think it's about time I leveled with you.
Oh?
You remember we met by accident last month? That was no accident. I heard you were in Ted Michael's office, and I deliberately dropped in.
Why?
I heard you on the radio a couple of months ago, and I started thinking about you. Which brings me to the question I started to ask the other night.
Mom, when did you get here?
A few minutes ago. You know, that's the happiest I've seen you look in a couple of weeks.
We were just killing time. We weren't really that happy.
You don't have to apologize for enjoying yourselves.
Hey, how was your evening, Mom?
Did he pop the question?
Yes, he did.
Well, what was your answer?
Maybe I should tell you what the question was first. He wanted to know if I would look at some songs he had written.
Kidding.
Some songs?
You mean we gave up a whole career for some doctor who writes songs as a hobby?
What do you mean you gave up a whole career for that?
Mom, maybe you better sit down. We'd like to talk with you about something.
What?
A gap we've been having.
Generation?
Communications.
Tell me honestly, Mom. Weren't you just a little bit disappointed when you found out it wasn't a marriage proposal?
Matter of fact, I was rather relieved.
I thought you liked him.
I do.
Nothing more, huh?
You know, Laurie, I think every woman falls a little bit in love with her obstetrician. Only during the past couple of weeks did I realize I liked Jim best when I was pregnant. I think that would be putting an awful burden on our relationship, don't you?
Yeah, I could see how that could be quite a drag.
Hey, we just played Dr. Lucas's music.
How is it?
It stinks.
Why does that make you happy?
Well, the music stinks. The lyrics are great. They sound like poetry.
Yeah, you know, I'd like to take a crack at writing some new music for them. Think you mind?
Well, I'm sure he wouldn't.
Of course it'd mean sharing the royalties with us. You better explain that to him very carefully.
Don't worry, Danny. Dr. Lucas will be very familiar with that arrangement.
Yeah?
Yeah. I believe they call it splitting. You don't understand. Be splitting.